Follow along with me today and learn some handy skills for making 3D fur in Adobe Illustrator. Now you're going to learn about swatches for gradient use, blend techniques, and other skills within today's tutorial, so let's get right into it. Now we first need to make a swatch collection so we can easily apply our chosen colors to a gradient. So go ahead and press M for the rectangle tool, and then hold down shift and click and drag to make a square like so. Now apply your first color as you see fit, and then hold down the Alt Option key and click and drag to duplicate that shape right down below. Now double click the color palette and adjust the color of the second shape using the slider. Now you can generate as many colors as you wish for your gradient, but I'm going to shoot for 5 colors for my design in total. Now when you've chosen your color palette, we're going to go ahead and make the swatches for the 3D fur design. So open up the swatches window and then create a new folder like so. So now it's just a case of selecting each square and then dragging the color into the swatch group folder. When you've actually got your swatch selection ready, let's now head into the actual 3D fuzzy fur design that you've clicked on this tutorial for. Now we want to make a circle with a stroke outline, so make sure there is no color fill in the color palette, and then press L for the ellipse tool. Hold down shift and click and drag as we did with the square earlier. Now press C on your keyboard, which is going to access the scissors tool, and then click once at the very top here, and then give a second click somewhere else along the vector path. Now press V for the selection tool and click the small section that we cut out, and then press backspace on your keyboard to remove and delete it. Now we're going to leave this cutout circle design right here for now, but again using the ellipse tool, make a circle with a fill color, but then add a gradient fill by clicking the gradient fill option in the color palette. Now the gradient window should open up, and to add a new color node, simply click on the slider, and to remove them, just click and drag them below. Now I have 5 nodes for my 5 color gradient, and to add your gradients, simply double click the node and then locate your swatch group here. So go ahead and add each of the gradient colors to each node for your 3D fur design. Now we actually need 2 circles, and that's simply done by again holding down the Alt Option key and then clicking and dragging below. So now we need to press W on your keyboard, or you can just click the blend tool here. But with the blend tool selected, hold down shift and click both of your circles. This will make a blend, and yours probably doesn't look like mine. But to adjust the blend, hold down the Alt Option key and click somewhere along the blend. We're going to be using the specified distance option, and I'm personally using 1.2. So do choose something close to that measurement for your design. So we're close to the finishing line for the 3D fur design, and now we want to select the blend and our circular shape, and then head up to Objects, Blend, and then Replace Spine. Now you most likely need to adjust the ends of your vector path, so press A for the Direct Selection tool, click once on the circular path, and then press V for the Selection tool. You can now rotate and change the scale of the circle as you see fit. And I personally really like making one end really tiny and the other end rather large. So we're nearly ready to add the final finishing touches to our 3D fur in Illustrator. And with your design selected, head into Effect, Distort and Transform, and then Roughen. Do make sure to click the preview box so you can see your changes in real time. Now, I like to increase the detail slider quite a lot, and then the size slider is something you're going to want to experiment with depending on the size of your design. We're not finished yet though, guys, and I do have a couple more tips to show you that you will want to take notice of. So once you have your design, it's wise to come into the object window and expand the appearance. Now this is done because we want to scale the design to different sizes and still keep the effects the same, and they will remain in proportion. Now the last effect that you want to add to the 3D fur that is really going to set it off and complete the design is to add a shadow below your design. So open up the gradient window and make sure you have only two color nodes, as well as making use of the radial gradient option. Now select the same color for both nodes and try to choose a dark gray or an almost black in color. But for the outer node, make sure to use 10% as the opacity. Now go ahead and press L for the ellipse tool and make an oval shape below like so. And finally, add a Gaussian blur effect in the effects panel. Now if your blur looks very glitchy and pixelated, you're going to want to increase the document raster effects numerals right here. Now by default they're probably set to 36, but I increase them to 300. You can see more videos just like this one linked down below, or you can click one on screen right here. And if you want to keep learning essential skills as a graphic designer, remember to subscribe to my channel for weekly graphic design content. We're now headed into 2020, so I hope you all are having a very positive start to this new year and a new decade, and I will see you back very soon for more graphic design content. And remember guys, design your future today. Peace.